Five schools here call it the last resort, but now the controversial isolation room has been banned from schools in the state of Illinois, and schools are looking to what's next now that using these rooms is off limits. WGEM's Frank Healy joins us with more. Frank?
Dylan, officials at Chaddock School say this isolated room is designed to help de-escalate potentially dangerous conflict with students. Yesterday, Governor Pritzker ordered a ban on the rooms after reports of misuse. When that order was passed down by the State Board of Education, local educators say they fell in line.
When we utilize the isolation room, it is absolutely that last resort when you put the student or others at risk or safety concern.
Chaddock High School Assistant Principal Caitlin Kegley says having a student go into a room like this to be monitored and talked with was rare. By design, the lock requires someone to be there, part of the strict protocol for the room's use.
Because it's not something that you can lock and walk away, you absolutely had to be there, still engaging with our students.
And administrators here at Chaddock say bans like these were already something on their radar. And when the order came down, they moved quickly.
We're a trauma-informed school, so we've known this was coming. And in fact, we have lots of students from across the country who come to us from states where this has already been banned.
Chaddock School Director of Education Corey Powell says within 10 minutes of getting the email, he sent the order to teachers. He says while he hopes legislators take the matter seriously, he doesn't expect to see the ban go away.
And so we're going to have to come up with some other strategies to work with those students, and we're ready to do that.
Kegley says instead of using the room, other de-escalation techniques like unlocked relaxation rooms or sensory rooms that provide positive stimulation can be used.
So our supports always begin within the classroom setting and how we can support those. So we've got our trained special education teachers and our paraprofessionals, as well as our behavior managers. So essentially we're going to start there. So how can we support you within the classroom? If not, that is where we then use therapeutic interventions.
Chaddock school officials say most of the time the isolation room wasn't even used as an isolation room, but instead as a place some students would go willingly to be left alone while they cool down. Frank Healy, WGEM News.